Good evening, everyone. This is Vinod from Tally ERP and Snippet. This is your video number 7, how to add opening balance if you have two different locations. Let's go. So let's see how to feed them up. And this is the continuation video of the godown or the opening stock video that I have just added before, the video number 6, where I talked about how to add a simple opening stock here. So here we are going to learn two different new logics here compared to the previous video. The first logic is, how do you bring in godown in Tally, which is not a default feature in Tally available for us. We need to add a feature to add a godown to us. And I'm going to add one more dimension of configuration, which I showed you in the earlier video, but I never used it. So we are about to see how to do that. So let's see and how to feed an opening stock. I'm not going to go for the entire video, so I'm going to just take one topic and I'm going to show you two different ways of feeding it. Let's jump into Tally. So I've already created a company here, so I don't want to waste a lot of time on doing it. So when I go back to our inventory information, you can only see the option that I saw in my previous video. What I said in this topic is, I'm going to create an opening stock by godown allocation too. So how do I allocate if I don't have a godown? So this is where my feature comes into play. I'm going to go back to my F11 feature, go to my inventory feature, and I'm going to set the third option, that is maintain multiple godown as yes, and save it. Control A will allow us to save it. Now when I go back to my list, you can see a godown. If you remember in my previous video, I told that we don't have anything by default when it comes to the inventory part, because inventory part is not universally same. Each and every company uses inventory in its own way possible. So nothing universe about an inventory. But again, you may have it, but again, that can be varied according to the situation. So Tally didn't allow us to have anything by default other than this particular point. The godown, we have one default godown already built in Tally. So it is called as main location. This is the default godown available in Tally for us. If you want to create further more godown, you can do that. Let's see what is the axis that we are about to see in here. I'm going to do one by one. I'm going to do all of them in one shot. So this is the Tally product. Again, this is a little old price list of Tally, originally rather. So I just activated my godown so that I got my godown there, and I'm going to create two godowns right now. And when I do this, again, I'm going to follow the same rule what I did in my previous exercise. I said that I'm about to create the units of measures first and stock item last. So you can create the other component as and how you want it to be. I am planning to create the first topic alone, the Tally software alone, and I want to show a report there. So I don't want to take too much of time. So the logic for creating this will be more than enough to work with inventory using a godown. Let's create the units of measures, but the units of measures is not given, so I consider the units as numbers or packs. So I'm using numbers a lot used, and I always give the number of decimal position as 2. Then I'm going to create group. So I'm just going on the basics of the list here, so I'm not going to do anything separate. I'm going to say Tally software, and I'm going to just set this as yes. So as it's a first group, creating them under, and I'm going to create new logic called godown. I have two godowns here, Chennai and Bengaluru. Selecting the Chennai, and I'm creating Bengaluru. Now I'm going to create my item. So there will be a subtle variances when we work with the stock item creation right now. The first point is, in my list I have the cost, price and sale. Remember, I'm giving a very basic offer. I'll give you one tip when I go for the addition of cost prices here. So when I go down to this portion, I'm going to create the first item. It is called Tally 7.2 single user. And I'm going to call it under Tally software and numbers. And you can see that there is a line comes here. In the previous exercise, I just gave two enters and skipped this point out because I never had a cost price selling price. Now I can add. I'm just giving you the current year. This is my cost and this is my sale price. When I deal with the cost base and selling price, I can add multiple points. For example, every day if the pricing changes, okay, generally Tally doesn't change in that way, but in a point it changes, but some products might have a different valuation. So for example, take a petrol right now. So in the last 10 days it was switched from 69 rupees to 80 rupees and plus. I don't know what is the current today's petrol rate, and it's changing every day. If I want a change something like this, at least a daily basis or on a monthly basis, I can set them here. So I can always set multiple dates here. So when I make an entry, the system understand when I made an entry on 2nd, the pricing of the sale will automatically become 7250. And if I'm buying from the supplier and if I know the price of the guy, then I can add the selling price. I can define it if I know the purchase price. So based on standard cost, my selling price might vary accordingly. This can be done even for a monthly basis. So I'm going to just say this is going to happen on 1/6/2020. And I can set this as once from 1/6/2020, the pricing is switched from 4950 to 4975 and 7200 to 7250. I'm going to give an enter and save it. And this is of no use when I create a master, but when I make an entry, it's going to be a very useful topic. Then when I come down to my list, I'm not going to punch any of the transactions or any of the numbers that is given below the godown. I'm going to take the total quantity into consideration. So I'm going to press 8 here, then it's asking you a question. So I'm going to pick up the Chennai and I'm going to say I have 5 stock in Chennai and I'm going to take the cost price here because this is the stock cost at which I'm dealing with it. When I give the Chennai quantity and give the valuation, give an enter, automatically the second name comes into play because my total quantity was 8. So the balance quantity is automatically switched. If I have more than 2-3 godowns, then I can bifurcate them manually. If not, it's going to allocate the balance automatically to the next godown that I'm going to select. Cost price remains same. Before I save it, I'll see the total value in here. That is 39,600. The same values are here available on the list. So I'm going to just give an enter and save it. If I want to just change the last few letters of the transaction, so I'm going to give Control R. Control R repeats whatever I typed in the previous item. I'm going to change that alone. This will save a little bit of time. If you are typing one kind of an item, I'm only changing maybe the colors or the patterns or the size at the last. Our inventories are designed in such a way, then it's easier for us to correct the final part alone. That's what I did right now. So I'm going to give an enter and set this as yes. As usual, I'm going to just set the pricing in here and the prices here. And the quantum comes into place as 5. 3 belongs to Chennai. And the cost is 13,500. And Bengaluru has the balance. Now, I may not be able to do that. So probably I can do that if you wanted to. So I'm going to just change this to 9.0. SU. The list here comes in. And then I'm going to say yes. Set the price here. These are all price again. I'm just taking it for an exercise here. So total quantity. I possess 10 of them. The balance goes to Bengaluru. Now I'm going to change the last part of it. So I'm going to just convert that to the multi-user. Just be able to control R and then just read what is required there. Total quantum that I have is 8, Chennai versus 5, and B goes to Bengaluru. And now I have a different item, so let me type it because adding this is going to become a little tougher for us. Then I give the valuation here. Just say the cost of it. So now I have equal quantities in both the godowns. Finally, I have the multi-user coming up here. The pricing. This time Chennai only have very little, most of them are in Bengaluru. So now I added all of the items. one by one. I didn't use the multiple stock item creation in this exercise because I wish to show you the control R shortcut here, which I don't want to use it in a multiple point. So I'm going to just come out of the screen and go back to my stock summary. You can see the total value of 1420,600 is here. When I give an Alt F1, you can see the particular item. But what I want is I want to even see the go down here. How do I bring that to? So to bring in the go down, I'm going to go back to my configuration again, jump to the last line and say yes. And that gives you a detailed information. The F12 configuration, the last line is expand all level in detail format. So I'm going to just give an S here. So that allows you to get the data until the last line exists. So the last line that exists in here is my codons. So I can see the codon part here. Again, it's too clumsy to see this as a report, but I want to see them as a separate report. I do have a report for that. So to do that, I'm going to go back to display and I will go back to my inventory books, statement of inventory, down, and I can pick all the items like this. So you can see that how many stock that I have in Bengaluru, how many stock that I have in Chennai. When I give an Alt F1, you can see the list. If you want this to expand to all level, go back to the F12 configuration, go to the last line. Yes. Now I can see each and every item with a breakup in it. I can see this with each and every item too on a codon. So Chennai, then I don't want to use the breakup here. Now I'm adding one more logic here. This is something which we generally talk in the point. I want to see both the codons simultaneously by two columns. So this is where I'm going to use in the reporting part. I'm going to add a new column here. And I'm going to just change reporting. So now we can see all of them here. So seeing one by one, seeing the comparison between these two. So Chennai has more stock on a whole, but in some cases, Bengaluru has more compared to Chennai. Some cases it is equalized. This is how we can see around our codon wise stock breakup, what I have. Hope you learn something new. A new variety of reports are coming up in our list. I can see all this logic once I started adding transactions. Let's go to the transaction in our upcoming video, and the next video will be on transactions. So we have done with our masters, accounts info and an inventory info. Now we are going to jump to the next logic called accounting voucher. So I'm going to take almost all the 8 vouchers in one shot. So I'll just take one dimension of data and I'll build one and then I'll give you the rest. So you're ready to make up your transactions right now in Tally. Hope you enjoyed and learned something new. This is Vinod signing off from Tally ERP and Snippet. This is your video number 7. If you have never subscribed to the channel, please subscribe to the channel. Do like it, do comment it if you want anything specific. I will add that as a video. This will be a separate video on bookkeeping series. If you have doubts, we can have a separate series of data on that too. Hoping and waiting for a lot of comments to come up. You know, signing out. Stay safe, stay updated, learn more.